Yeah, fools.
Big T here, and I'm back with another video. This video will be kind of an expansion on the topic video I did recently about what I don't need on my Nintendo Switch. I think some people might have taken that wrong. I was speaking specifically about what I don't care for, and I wasn't saying that those options shouldn't be available or anything like that. It's just what, you know, I was just basically saying what I didn't care for. Media apps and things like that. And I just felt like a lot of people today, most gamers especially, I would think, have other devices that, you know, they would use over the Nintendo Switch that function better, you know, because I recently watched a movie on my iPad. It was at 100%, and it was like a 2-hour movie, and by the time it was done, my iPad was still at 84%. So, obviously the battery life is much better for things like that on devices that I feel like are better catered to that. And that's all I was basically saying. But I also touched on the virtual console and, you know, me not wanting to have to pay again for games that I bought on previous virtual consoles on the Wii and Wii U. I would like Nintendo to find some kind of way to have me bring my stuff over. Maybe, again, like they did with the Wii U from Wii, where I pay like a smaller fee to get those games on to Switch. That would be fine. We're not really sure what Nintendo's going to be doing with the virtual console at this point. You know, I think they even said it won't be a traditional virtual console, basically. So I think it's going to be more in line with what they've been doing with the basically with the Neo Geo stuff they've been doing, where they just, you know, put the game out there. They don't call it a virtual console. It's not a separate thing. You just kind of buy the game, you know. So I think that's probably what they're going to be doing with the Switch eventually. But I didn't really delve into, I think, which is my main reason I didn't care for virtual console, especially at this point. You had like indie companies come out and say how well they're doing on the Switch. The creators of Wonder Boy talked about it. The creators of SteamWorld Dig 2 talked about how successful, especially over the other versions on other consoles and platforms, how successful they've been on the Switch thus far. You got other indie titles coming in. You know, a lot of indie titles seem to be doing really well on the Switch, and the Switch is quickly becoming the go-to indie platform, which is very cool. And that is my main reason I don't care for virtual console, because I feel like, especially right now, virtual console could totally cannibalize what's happening, the success of what's happening with those companies. Because if you just drop virtual console, especially to the extent that most people want it, I don't want to trickle out situation with the virtual console. A lot of people say that they were upset about how the Wii U virtual console went down. They didn't like the trickle out nature of it. They wanted more games. And I just feel like if indie companies are going to have to compete with legacy Nintendo games or legacy console games from previous Nintendo consoles, classics and stuff like that, they're going to have a harder time selling their newer games. And I think I alluded to that by saying I'm more focused on wanting newer games on my new platform, the Switch. And basically, that's kind of what I was talking about. I don't want these indie companies to have to compete with 20 to 30 year old games that we all have a special place in our hearts and minds as gamers, of having played those games previously. And you got to sit there and make a decision on what you're going to buy to download on the eShop. Are you going to buy Super Mario World again? Or are you going to buy Runner 3? You know, something like that. And that could be a choice that a lot of gamers have to make. Not everybody can just buy everything. So some gamers have to make the choice. Do they want those legacy titles on the go, which is very compelling? Or do they want newer indie titles? And for me, I would rather the indie companies do well and do better. Yes, they can coexist. I understand. I know that comic is already being typed as I speak. But there's no way that virtual console, especially a robust virtual console on Switch, is not going to negatively affect the attention and sales potential for indie companies and indie games. It's just, it's not possible. There's no way it's going to happen. So, yeah, I just wanted to basically, you know, let you guys know specifically about, I think, the most important thing when it comes to why I don't care for virtual console at this particular moment. Maybe, you know, later on down the line, when Switch has been around a couple years or so, when, you know, some of the indie sales have plateaued, that's probably going to happen. And Nintendo Switch is, you know, very popular right now, selling crazy right now, and, you know, a lot of stuff that comes out on it is going to do well initially. That may not be the case over its entire life. You've seen drop off from things like Steam, because once there's enough stuff on there, a lot of the stuff gets buried and you don't see it as much. But with Steam specifically, it's stuff gets buried because of the free-to-play stuff, and you kind of miss some of the good games that you could have, like, you know. That's just a natural thing, but, and that, you know, that may occur with eShop just naturally too, where it doesn't matter about the virtual console. It's just that by the time there's a lot of games on there, maybe games won't do well. But that may not be the case. Maybe a new game, as long as there's not too many new indie games at once, maybe those games will still breathe and still have some great sales potential. But, you know, that's basically the main reason I don't care for virtual console at this moment. I'm not going crazy about it. I mean, obviously, I wouldn't mind if it's there, but it being there would make me worry about the future sales potential of indie titles. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Do you agree with me? Disagree? Do you just want everything all at once slapped onto the Switch and, you know, and see what happens? And hope for the best? Or I like what Nintendo's been doing, basically, where they've been kind of being very measured and very strategic as far as what they're releasing on the console. And, you know, I think they'll do that for, I think they'll do that focus for at least the first couple of years. They may do it for the entire life cycle, who knows, but I think they want to make sure everybody gets a chance to see great games and play great games as they come and not be overwhelmed and not have too much stuff at once. So yeah, like I said, let me know in the comments below how you feel about this. Thank you, as always, for watching and listening, and I'll see you fools next time. Peace out.